Arise, O Lord, let not man prevail. Let the heathen be judged in thy sight. Put them in fear, O Lord, that the nations may know themselves to be but men.
We move to Colorado and the desperate search there for at least three people missing after one of the most destructive wildfires in the state's history. A blanket of snow is now covering the area where nearly 1,000 homes were destroyed.
A blanket of snow is now covering the area where nearly 1,000 homes were destroyed.
And President Biden has approved a federal disaster declaration, freeing up funds for those affected.
Fire and hail, snow and vapor, stormy wind fulfilling his word.
The views expressed on this channel are those of the video's creator, and not those of YouTube, Google, their staff, and or affiliates. YouTube, Google, their staff, and or affiliates shall not be held liable for the views, expressions, and comments made on this channel.
YouTube deleted the main Omega Watchman channel, stating that God's word in relation to current events is cyberbullying and medical misinformation. Thus, YouTube deleted the channel and 80,000 subscribers with over 20 million views. This is nothing and will not stop us. YouTube, do you honestly think by deleting our content and channels that it will stop the wrath of God? How silly. Attention YouTube. All of the clips used in this video are recorded directly from your platform, according to fair use guidelines. Further, YouTube has not deleted the videos of which the clips in this video are recorded from. YouTube has not labeled those as a conspiracy, medical misinformation, or cyberbullying. Thus, if YouTube deletes this video or channel, it will prove religious discrimination, as our content and channels are being deleted simply for putting the word of God in relation to these clips and current events. Enjoy the wrath of God.
This is an Omega Watchman Media Group production.
Due to the mature nature of this content, language, and death, viewer discretion is advised.
For hundreds of families in Colorado, the new year ringing in a harsh reality. There's no returning home from the holidays. Nearly 1,000 homes incinerated and more than 100 additional damaged.
People are saying Happy New Year and it's kind of far from that.
Hast thou entered into the treasures of the snow? Or hast thou seen the treasures of the hail which I have reserved against the time of trouble, against the day of battle and war?
This is an Omega Watchman Media Group production.
Superior and Louisville, apocalyptic wastelands, unrecognizable even to longtime residents. The Marshall Fire, now the most destructive in state history.
The Marshall Fire, now the most destructive in state history.
Fire and hail, snow and vapor, stormy wind fulfilling his word.
You know, it almost seems like a tornado, a hurricane, a fire, all in one.
You know, it almost seems like a tornado, a hurricane, a fire, all
fire
in one.
Fire and hail, snow and vapor, stormy wind fulfilling his word.
Tonight, the destruction is catastrophic as fast-moving infernos raged across Colorado, more than tripling in size in less than 24 hours. Tearing through residential neighborhoods near Boulder like a blowtorch, fueled by intense 100-mile-an-hour winds.
It was pretty shocking. The winds were blowing embers all over the road. Old Town Superior was on fire. Just unbelievable.
Chaos and confusion as tens of thousands scrambled for their lives.
Right or left?
Shoppers fleeing a Costco with a doomsday scenario closing in.
You know, it almost seems like a tornado, a hurricane, a fire, all in one.
President Biden promising federal assistance as today Colorado's governor surveyed the damage from the air. Entire communities now an apocalyptic wasteland.
Have you seen anything like this before?
Well, nothing with the pace of this fire. This one was right in, you know, your neighborhood Target, your neighborhood Costco. The hospital had to be evacuated. So this was a fast-moving urban and suburban fire.
The estimated toll, now upwards of 1,000 homes damaged or destroyed. The Marshall Fire poised to be the most destructive blaze in Colorado history for property loss. The cause still under investigation.
Our neighborhood was pretty engulfed in smoke.
Among the residents who will return to nothing, college football coach Mark Smith.
We've gotten some reports from some of our neighbors that our entire street is gone. And that's just hard to swallow.
Still tonight, a sigh of relief. Amid so much devastation, few reported injuries and officials holding out hope for no loss of life.
If we can emerge from this without any fatalities, that's nothing short of a New Year's miracle.
And Emily Akata joins us live from Boulder, Colorado. Now, Emily, what progress are firefighters making? They're trying to put out those fires, certainly getting help from the snow.
Yet amid utter devastation, remarkable stories of survival. Patients were able to evacuate a hospital, a staff hosed down flames rushing towards oxygen tanks.
It is a miracle that did not happen.
And at a nearby mall, Catherine Lopez.
Your car was running out of gas, you were stuck in traffic, the flames are closing in. What's going through your mind?
That I just wanted to get out safe to my family. I even, told my son, I left him. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get out.
But she did, thanks to a fast-acting police officer who drove her out of the danger zone.
And I'm so thankful and grateful.
This is an Omega Watchman Media Group production.
We moved to Colorado and the desperate search there for at least three people missing after one of the most destructive wildfires in the state's history. A blanket of snow is now covering the area where nearly 1,000 homes were destroyed. And President Biden has approved a federal disaster declaration, freeing up funds for those affected. Here's ABC's Zorin Shaw.
Tonight, Colorado officials urgently searching for three people missing after the 6,000-acre Marshall Fire tore through Boulder County, torching an estimated 1,000 homes.
The debris is hot. It's all fallen in, and it's now covered with 8 inches of snow. So search and recovery efforts are hampered substantially.
In the aftermath, families taking account of what remains.
Everything looks like it could be out of a movie, and who would have ever thought that this fire would have happened in Louisville?
State officials say they've never seen an inferno so destructive rip through suburban neighborhoods. Today, a Colorado snowfall arriving, wrapping entire scorched neighborhoods in white. Debris still smoldering underneath, raising the question, what if it had come sooner?
24 hours earlier would have been such a blessing.
The snow has helped tame the monstrous Marshall Fire, but it's complicating the recovery process.
Fire and hail, snow and vapor, stormy wind fulfilling his word.
I think right now it's pretty surreal. I mean, not doing well. My dad used to just walk across the street to the golf course.
People are saying Happy New Year, and it's kind of far from that.